attention for a moment. The idea really, as you fill in the forms, our sort of, if you like, the guidelines that we've been using is from 0 to 4. So we try really to see where is the, not from individual level, but from a good sample, which we trying about 300 to 400 professional, where are we in the journey, sort of from in terms of knowledge and skills, as time is progressing forward. So there's no shame of someone who's doing some work, but you're not really that much on the BIM journey. But the idea is to see whether you're basic, you are entry. As I said, it's not your individual, but for the whole sample. And the idea is how to move them from being basic to the next phase, and from the next phase to the third phase. So that is what's needed in terms of skill and knowledge. What sort of more training needed, what sort of more educational in terms of the courses, and that is how, so this is why it might look a little bit long in terms of the questionnaire, but I can assure you some of it, if it's not applicable, just say not applicable. If you're not 3D modeler, you must say 2 or 3 pages. You're not 3D modeler, you work in certain part, and this is where we wanted to know where the gaps are in terms of the BIM journey and how we kind of sort this out. So as you can see, as we move here from left to the right, and there are the questionnaires is focusing on these different different areas, which is about 8 areas in terms of the skills and the knowledge, and this is where we needed to come up with some sort of sensible assessment of what's going on and how we're going to move to the next phase in terms of the, and I'm sure some of you might know that the Shalal has been investing heavily in the way that they wanted their work and their documentation to be all BIM enabled, and this is where we trying to help them in order to get into the journey. So just shout if you have a question, and I'm happy to come on board. If something is not really clear, just say I don't know because it's not your work. You don't have to be 3D model if you're not, because some of it is you're not 3D modeler. You are more into structural design, structural engineering, something that you do. This is for cross section, cross sector in the industry. So start from people who are doing sort of 3D modeling, etc., down to the people who are managing others in terms of the strategic project managers. So if you're a project manager, you're going to have to know how 3D is modeled. You need to know how function, what the function is going to serve, and is going to help you in order to pass information from one phase to another. So that's the sort of areas that we need to do. So we're going to put some of the questions here. If you have any queries, happy to support you. Thank you.